Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we have made it into the Christmas months. It is the 3rd of December, and today, West Ham United are playing Arsenal at home in the London Stadium. It's been a bloody long time since we've been there. I've been to Manchester twice. We've been all over. We're out the cup. Let's move on to better things. Hopefully today we can pull off a performance. I'm not too hopeful because Arsenal are looking incredible right now. Antonio and Cresswell are out injured. It's not looking great for us. Anyway, the plan of action today is to go down to the Hammers chat boats, linking up with the boys again. I'm going to meet Charlie down there. Then we're going to go into the stadium, watch the game. And I'm praying that we can maybe just pull out a result today. I think Andy Carroll might be back. And last time he did score, he scored a few goals against Arsenal. So who knows what will happen. Let's just see and hope if we can even manage to grab a draw or something. It's got to the stage where I'm still hopeful. I'm still hopeful in the boys, okay? I'm still very hopeful in the boys. But you have to sit down and be realistic. Arsenal are playing phenomenal football at the moment. Their defence is a bit questionable, but Koscielny, probably the best defender in the league. And yeah, it's game time, baby. Come on, you Lions.
Alright, rules of the raffle are simple. Someone's going to pick them out of the bucket. Everyone should have a ticket number. Those of you that are on the forum, I'll see you at the back, don't worry. Those of you on the forum, you're already entered into it. You can't hear?
Come up here then!
What a lovely walk to the stadium. Predictions, what are we saying? I'm saying, realistic world, probably 2-1 Arsenal. In my hopes and dreams, 2-1 West Ham. What are you saying, Tom?
What am I saying? I'm saying, in my hopes and dreams, like you said, 2-1 West Ham, but Arsenal got to be 2-1 win, surely, because of the fact they've rested players midweek.
Yeah? Okay, fair enough. Charlie, what are you saying? Realistic?
Alright, it's going to be 2-0 Arsenal.
Yeah, realistic 2-0 Arsenal. And what are you saying? Hopeful. Hopeful dreams.
Hopes and dreams.
Carroll comes in and gets a brace.
I'm hoping it's going to be a 3-2 West Ham.
There we go.
Alright, so it's gonna be either a 2-0 to Arsenal, or 3-1, or a 3-2.
Okay. Anyway, we're off to the stadium. Beautiful, beautiful, good old place. Well, I mean, we haven't been playing great yet. But anyway, we're off to the stadium. Gonna go and watch the match. Let's enjoy it. Come on, you Irons! Irons!
Join us now as we unite to pay our respects to all those who lost their lives in last week's tragic accident in Colombia, including the 19 players and officials from Brazilian football club Chapecoense. A period of silence will begin and end on the referee's whistle.
Finally in the stadium, Charlie's going to get a sausage. Kickoff has begun. I'm hoping that we can get a result from this. A point would be delightful. Arsenal are on the attack. Let's just see what we can do. Come on, you Irons.
Oh, we've had a mare already.
All right, we are 7 minutes in. Collins has come off. Arbelow is on already. Absolute nightmare start already. I'm hoping for a point at least. Come on.
Arbelow, you nonce. Get off, Bonner. Come on, man.
Oh, Jesus. He didn't just send you
for it. Let's just yours, man.
Go on, son! Wait! That's it! Fucking hell!
Oh! Fucking hell. Come on, boy, shit!
That's schoolboy behaviour, bro. That's... schoolboy shit. Schoolboy.
Fucking hell. What a joke.
Right, okay, so we're 30 minutes into the game. Arsenal 1-0 up. We're being sliced open like fucking absolute butter. Charlie's got the other cam in case they score a goal.
Oh my God.
Randolph saves it, but Charlie, we're looking awful.
I predicted it.
We're looking awful. We need to drive forward. Fletcher looks like he's trying to have a good game, but the rest of the team, man, I don't know what's happening. But we're hoping to build. If we can get a goal back before half-time, or maybe after half-time, I'll be hopeful, but yes. Irons?
Yes.
Please.
Give him an option.
Go on, Pedro. Do it yourself, son. Go on. Yes, come on. Right, come on, Dimmy, son. Good ball in, good ball in.
Oh. They weren't even wrong.
Ball, ball. Oh, come on.
Right, we're on the half-time break, Charles. And what's your opinion?
Lackadaisical performance from the lads, to be honest.
Yeah.
I think we missed Antonio and Creswell. To be honest with you, without the width, and we don't have any strength really going forward with Antonio out.
Yeah.
Arbeloa, the training cone, is on the pitch.
Yeah. He's been exposed twice in the space of like 10 to 15 minutes.
He's worse at a right back than Antonio, and Antonio is not a right back. But I could talk for half an hour, like, easy about how bad this performance has been, basically.
Arsenal's goal, though. Ogbonna gives the ball away.
Yeah, that's surprising. Because Ogbonna is usually...
Ogbonna's been one of our statues in defence.
Yeah, Ogbonna and Reid are like two people who I'd say is the first people on the list of, like,
ladies and gentlemen, we always like to see a trophy at this ground, at London Stadium. And this trophy is to commemorate the Nigeria Federation Cup champions.
It's about the only trophy we're going to get this year. Let's pretend we scored.
apart from, like, this is what I was saying, like, Winston Reid and Ogbonna are like two people who I really think that are reliable people. And to give away a ball like that.
Big Andy.
Have a little warm up.
But yeah, two people like that.
And
Ogbonna gives the ball away, Reid gets done on the 50-50. Absolutely done on the 50-50.
It's a shame, but what are you going to do? Like, it happens. Everyone has a mistake, so you can't really say
it just came at the worst possible time.
I just think that with Fletcher, like, you take for example, that we've got Fletcher who's like somewhere between 18 to 20 years old.
Yeah.
Leading the line for a Premier League team at that young age.
Against Arsenal, against Koscielny, Mustafi.
Impossible. So you've got to have someone else. So I'm
throwing him in at the deep end.
I'm hoping Carroll comes on to support or even replace because he's got that experience.
Yeah.
That's all I can really say about it.
Half time though, first half pretty uninspiring to say the least. No real sure chances. And yeah, let's get on to the second half. Come on, you Irons. Let's do this.
Fortunes always hiding.
Got a free kick. Go on. Oh, he's offside, you little fuck. Dimmy delivers the ball in from a free kick. It was a potential chance. Still useless. 51 minutes played. Crying myself a river. I tell you what, this season in these vlogs, you can just see me getting older. I think I'm just getting older every month. Oh my god. Oh my god, they've nearly scored again. But honestly, if you do a time lapse of just my face, I think you can see the stress just building every game. Just like I said to Charlie, Fernandez to come off for IU, which is very promising. Now, all I'm hoping for is Andy Carroll to come on. But Charlie, guess what? Fernandez came off for IU. Guess what? Who's the tactical mastermind? Who is the tactical mastermind? Yeah, exactly. I'm the tactical mastermind. Payet just needed something incredible.
He ran off the pitch, that's what.
Yeah, exactly. You saw it. But Fernandez off, IU on. Let's hope something special.
Andy's just returned back to the bench. I think he's getting his kit on. I'm excited. Come on, Andy. Come on. Do the damn thing. Do the damn thing. Impact this game. We love you. We love you. You're our only hope. You're our only hope.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is exactly what Alexis Sanchez can do. He can be any side of the box and he can tuck that in bottom corner. 2-0, 70th minute, just as Andy Carroll's about to enter the field. 2-0 now. All I feel is that our team got.
Do you remember last game?
I do.
2-0 down, Andy Carroll.
No ball leaving the field for Andy Carroll. 2-0 though.
Come on, Andy!
I can only feel the 2-0 is nailing on it, but you never know. I'm very upset. Alexis Sanchez, you don't allow him that quality. Masuaku got exposed. That's what he does. That's exactly what he does. 2-0, Alexis Sanchez. Hey ho, let's hope Carroll can bag a brace from somewhere. Like I said, Sanchez will do that every day of the fucking week. First time, edge of the box, goal, 3-0, absolute joke. See you in a bit. See you in a fucking bit. See you in a bit. We are dire. I tell you what, that just sums up. We are fucking dire. Absolute dire. Randolph wants to break from a fucking goal kick, and there's eight players sitting in front of him, with two players making a run, and they're marked off.
What is this?
What is it?
Dimitri's got a free kick in the 82nd minute. I'm getting my camera out in the hopes of something special happens. Who fucking knows? Straight after that, I said, go on, make it 4-1. And guess what they've done? At Oxlade-Chamberlain, curls one sweetly into the bottom corner, and it's 4-1.
We're getting relegated, bro.
Bleach. Bleach. Bleach is needed. Shout me with some bleach. Who's a bleach supplier? Chuck me a gallon. We're fucking shit! We're fucking shit! I'm broken. I'm fucking broken. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is an Alexis Sanchez hat-trick. Watch out for the inform this week on FIFA. Thank you very much. Thanks for coming. Fuck me. We're just charity work. We do everyone's... I just farted. We just do charity work for the year. That's what we do. We just do charity work for the year. Go on. Come to the London Stadium. Take your 5 goals. See you in a bit.
All a load of rubbish. All a load of rubbish.
I don't want it to come across as if I'm like some sort of bad fan or anything, but what we've seen today...
No, there's only so much you can take. Look, we're here. Look at all these empty seats.
Look at that behind us, look. Look at that. I'm still sat here, just hope. I've got hope
what
that we're... Got hope we're going to bring back 5 goals in 3 minutes.
It's not even just that, it's just support your team to the end, isn't it? It's 90 minutes of your day of the week. It's just support your team.
I'm here to support us, but like...
But at least you call them out when they're shit.
When you're watching us fall, we're literally just bent over, that's it. We literally bent over. They scored 3 goals in like 5, 8 minutes, whatever it was. But we just bent over for it. Literally bent over for it.
Show them the stadium.
Are you ready for the stadium? Let alone this bare bit right here, okay? I'll Photoshop some fans in here, okay? Look, there's a good support.
But look at the stadium, look. Look at that. Look.
And that started happening from the 75th minute. That started happening. They missed our goal. A lot of people down here missed our goal. Missed our goal. And they're going to go home and see there is 5-1.
This is the first match of the day tonight, probably.
First for the wrong reasons, Charlie. All right, I've had enough.
Still, we win right. Something.
I'll see you at full time. It's definitely a chips day. Without a shadow, without chips. I'm going to go and warm up and cry myself to sleep. Lay down and try not to cry. There you have it, full time in the London Stadium. As you can see, look at that. Look at that. Look at it. We are shit. We are very shit. Full time. 5-1 Arsenal, hat-trick for Sanchez. See you in a bit. I'm gonna rant when I get home, okay? I'm fuming.
Right, guys, so after a very long, tiring, stressful day, we look back at the 5-1 defeat, utter destruction that Arsenal just laid upon West Ham. And to be honest, it was just so uninspiring. It was so uninspiring. It took Bilic to go 2-0 down. To be fair, he was preparing Carroll before the second goal, but 2-0 down to bring Carroll on to get a goal back. And then we just bent over. And then we just bent over and took it, okay? We just bent over and just handed it to him. Just handed it to him. Admittedly, we did have two main players out, Antonio and Creswell. Having them out of the team is a humongous loss, and I think that showed it today. Masuaku and Arbeloa. Collins had to go off injured early on in the game. Arbeloa. Don't know what he's doing. Masuaku got exposed for one of the goals, and it's just so uninspiring. The only two players in that team that know what a relegation battle is about. If we're about to be in a relegation battle, we'll see after Christmas. But if we're about to be in a relegation battle, the only couple of players in there that know about it are Reed and Noble. They're the only two. And Reed today was the only player on that pitch that I think that really shone for the West Ham team in general. And you might be thinking, saying that we conceded 5 goals, but seriously, he was probably the best player in that team today. Fletcher also put in a decent performance. Card not Fletch. He's just a young guy thrown in at the deep end. Who knows what's to come for him? But we reflect. 5-1 defeat. On to the next one. Away at Liverpool. I'm going to be there. Travelling up all the way from here. It's a 3.5 hour trip to Liverpool. To Anfield. Going to be watching that one. And let's just hope we don't get turned over again. Let's just hope. But who knows? Liverpool scoring goals for fun at the minute. It'll be an interesting one. That's going to be all for today's vlog. I hope you have enjoyed it. I've come home and slipped into my PJs and my loafers. just because it's a sad night, okay? It's a sad night. But yeah, if you have enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button. That'd be absolutely awesome. If you're new around it, want to hit subscribe. And I'll see you in the future for the next one in a bit. Come on, you Irons. Stay faithful. Let's do this.